Dear students, welcome to our YouTube channel Vidya for Success. In this video, let us continue our study on pteridophytes. Yes, now let us study regarding the classification of pteridophytes. So children, till now we have completed all the characteristic features of pteridophytes. So we understood that the main plant in a pteridophyte is sporophytic plant, and sporophytic plant produces spores, then spores germinates and develops into gametophytic plant. So the sporophytic plant, what the main plant is, alternates with the gametophytic phase, and gametophytic plant again forms the sporophytic plant by the formation of gametes. So this is what the complete life cycle we have studied in the pteridophytes. So based on certain characteristic features, the pteridophytic plants are classified into four different classes. So one of the class of pteridophyte is Psilopsida. It is also commonly called as whisk ferns. So the best example of plant we have is Psilotum. So why the Psilopsida is called as a whisk fern? Because they consist of many branches. So if you observe the stem in these Psilopsida members, they consist of number of branches. So this is the picture of a Psilotum plant. This is comes under the Psilopsida class. You can observe there the stem consists of branches. So when the stem is ready to form branches, at the same time it produces two lobes. So this is a very common feature, can be seen in all members of Psilopsida. So that they are commonly named as whisk ferns. So best example of plant we have here is Psilotum. This is the first one. And the second class is Lycopsida. So Lycopsida members are named as club mosses. So mosses is not new terminology for you, right? Because we have already studied it in the bryophyte. So why the pteridophytic plant is called as mosses? Why it is called as club mosses? It is a pteridophytic plant, right? So then also it is called as a club mosses, because it just appears like a mosses plant. So how the mosses are there in appearance, in the similar way Lycopsida plants are also appears. But during their reproduction, that means during the spore formation, they produces club shaped structure. The structure what is produces in the plant during the spore formation, that appears in club shape. So because of this, plants, that means the members of this plants are commonly named as club mosses. So the best example of plants we have here is Selaginella and Lycopsida. So we have already seen the Selaginella plant. So this is what the Selaginella plant. So commonly the members are named as club mosses. Then the one more is Spinopsida. So Spinopsida is commonly known as oersteids. So why they are called as oersteids? Because for appearing they looks like tails of oars. So the similar resemblance are there. The branches of the plant resembles like oars tail. So because of that, the Spinopsida members are commonly named as oersteids. So the best example is Equisetum. So this is what the Equisetum plant. So they usually form their own colonies. That means one plant is there means it will reproduces, so that nearby it forms its own colonies. Many plants will grow in the same locality, in the same area. So that all the plants colony, because of the plant colonies, the plants appears like horse tail. It is very straight, very erect. It looks like horse tails. So that the Spinopsida members are commonly known as horse tails. Then the last fourth one is Pteropsida. So Pteropsida members are commonly called as ferns. So the example is Dryopteris and Pteris. So the members of Pteropsida are ornamental. That means they are very attractive. So because of their appearance, they are commonly grown as an ornamental plant. So this is the fern plant. So I hope you have seen this kind of plant. So it is belonging to the category, that means it is belonging to the class Pteropsida. So these are the four different classes of pteridophytes. So children, you have to practice all these terminologies. Clear? So the first class is Psilopsida, second one is Lycopsida, third one is Pinopsida, fourth one is Pteropsida. And it is very easy to remember the examples because the name of the plant what we are studying here, that is similar with the name of classes. So Psilopsida, plant example is Psilotum. Lycopsida, plant example is, either you can give the example of Lycopsida or you can give the example of Selaginella. Spinopsida example is Equisetum. Then Pteropsida example is Pteris, or you can give the example of Dryopteris. Understood? Yes. So pteridophytic plants are very useful to us. So we have some of the economic importance from the members of pteridophytes, so that they are very useful to us. So one of the economic importance is the plants are grown as ornamental plants. So the best example of plant here is ferns. So ferns are grown as ornamental plants because they are very showy in appearance and the leaves are very graceful. That means they always be green in color and they look very fresh. So because of these characters, ferns are grown as ornamental plants. Then some of the members of pteridophytes are used as a food. So the best example of pteridophytic plant used as a food is Marsilia. So Marsilia is an aquatic plant. This plant produces sporocarp during the spore formation. So sporocarp is actually a structure. Within that structure, spore formation takes place. That sporocarp actually rich in starch. So because of the large amount of starch content, this part is used as a food by tribals. So we know, children's, right? Starch is very essential to our body. So some of the vegetables what we are taking as a part of our food, they are rich in starch. Best example is potato. Potato is very rich in starch. So in the similar way, sporocarp also consists of starch. Because of this, the tribal people has been used this as a food. Then one more use is, this is the Marsilia plant. You can see this is aquatic in its habitat and this will produce a sporocarp during the reproduction, that is a source of food. Then one more use is, the plants are used as a source of medicine. So some of the diseases like infections with the parasitic worms, those kinds of diseases actually treated by the drugs extracted from the pteridophytic plant. So that the drugs are actually called as anti-helminthic. So anti-helminthic is nothing but they are against the helminths. You can take the example of tapeworms. So tapeworms are parasitic to our intestine. So in order to get rid, in order to reduce their multiplication in the intestine, the medicine extracted from the pteridophytic plant is used. So that the drugs extracted from the pteridophytic plants are commonly named as anti-helminthic. So it is actually obtained from one of the plant that is named as Dryopteris. Clear? And one more importance is, they also act as a soil binders. So many pteridophytes grow on slopes. So we know pteridophytic plants are restricted to narrow geographical area. Where the slopey area is present, in that particular area we can see many pteridophytic plant. So that the growth of pteridophytes, especially on the slope, helps to bind the soil and prevents the soil erosion. So you just imagine, the number of pteridophytic plants are more on the slope. So when the plants are more, their root tightly binds with the soil. So this will helpful to prevent the soil erosion. So the amount of soil erosion get reduces by the thick growth of pteridophytic plants on slopes. Then some of the plants are used as a scouring. So something which is used to clean or brighten the surface of things are named as scouring. So one of the plant best example of plant used act as a scouring is Equisetum plant. So stem of the Equisetum is actually very tough, and its surface is like the scrubber surface. So scrubber we usually use in our kitchen in order to remove the tough stains from the utensil surface. So the similar texture we have in the Equisetum stem also. So because of this nature, the stem of Equisetum is used in order to clean the surface of utensils like pots and pans, and also it is used to clean the surface of floor. And sometime because of this nature, scrubby nature, the stem is used to polish the metal surface because it will brighten the surface of metal. So Equisetum plant is the best example of plant used to clean the surface of utensil. So this is the Equisetum plant. You can notice the stem is very tough, and because of this nature only it is used to clean the utensils. Understood, children? So these are the few economic importance what we are getting by pteridophytic plants. So different members are used in different ways. So these are the uses what we are getting. Understood? So by this I will end my discussion on the pteridophytic plants. So here in this lesson we discussed many things regarding the pteridophytic plants. So first we have studied about the characteristic features. So there we understood the main plant is sporophytic plant, and the dominant phase is also sporophytic, and the gametophytic generation also we have seen in the pteridophytes. And next to the characteristic features, we have studied the classification of pteridophytes, and also we discussed some of the economic importances of pteridophytic plants. Understood? So I hope you understood all the concepts what I discussed with you regarding the pteridophytes. Yes, thank you.